Hi, I'm Dr. Ambreesh Chawla from the Cleveland Clinic. I wanted to share an interesting case of new onset IgG4-related disease that we have seen in our clinic. This case illustrates the many faces of IgG4-related disease with varying patient symptoms and organ involvement. We have a 67-year-old African-American female with a past medical history of endometrial adenocarcinoma, status post surgical resection and chemotherapy, hypertension, epilepsy, and migraines, who is referred to our clinic for concerns of Sjogren's disease due to progressive sicca symptoms and glandular enlargement. Initial CT scan of her neck demonstrated bilateral enlarged submandibular glands without ductal dilation or submandibular stones. Labs revealed elevated markers of inflammation of ESR and C-reactive protein with a negative ANA, ENA, including SSA and SSB antibodies. Her rheumatoid factor was borderline positive and CCP antibody was negative. Immunoglobulin E levels were found to be elevated. Additional laboratory testing yielded an elevated IgG and serum IgG4 subclass level. Incisional biopsy of her right submandibular gland showed chronic sclerosing sialadenitis, dense lymphoplasmacytic infiltrate, and polyclonal plasmacytosis. Majority of plasma cells on biopsy stained positive for IgG4 with an increased IgG4 to IgG ratio. CT scan of her chest demonstrated multiple pulmonary nodules and axillary lymphadenopathy. CT scan of her abdomen and pelvis demonstrated a 22.4 millimeter by 18.1 millimeter soft tissue lesion between the proximal common iliac arteries, eccentric soft tissue thickening along the left anterior lateral wall of the abdominal aorta, and mild infiltration adjacent to the distal abdominal aorta, which was concerning for retroperitoneal fibrosis. Subtle haziness adjacent to the pancreatic tail was also seen, which raised the possibility of autoimmune pancreatitis. Our patient was subsequently diagnosed with IgG4-related disease and was started on prednisone 40 milligrams per day, which was tapered over time, along with rituximab infusions. Within 2 months, the patient's serum IgG4 levels normalized. She experienced significant improvement in neck swelling, and CT abdomen demonstrated decrease in size of soft tissue thickening caudal to the aortic bifurcation. In summary, IgG4-related disease is a systemic disease characterized by tissue infiltration by IgG4-positive plasma cells and enlargement of affected organs. Approximately 40% of patients present with predominantly one organ involved, and 60% of patients have multi-organ involvement. Salivary gland disease and IgG4-related disease typically affects the submandibular glands more commonly than the parotid glands. This was previously known as Michelet's disease. In patients with sicca and salivary glandular enlargement, IgG4-related disease should always be on the differential, along with other conditions such as sarcoidosis, amyloidosis, diffuse idiopathic lymphocytosis syndrome, commonly associated with HIV, and hepatitis C infection, as well as other viral infections. Clinical findings and imaging, including CT, MRI, and PET scans, can help define the extent of IgG4-related disease. While serum elevations of IgG4 are non-diagnostic for IgG4-related disease, serum IgG4 can be a helpful biomarker once the diagnosis has been made. Outside of Sjogren's disease, IgG4-related disease may also share similar clinical features to granulomatosis with polyangiitis, known as GPA, including, but not limited to, vasculitis, pulmonary disease, renal disease, orbital mass, and pachymeningitis. The presence of neutrophils and necrosis on biopsy favor a diagnosis of GPA over IgG4-related disease. It is my hope that this case will bring awareness to the broad spectrum of clinical presentations that can be caused by IgG4-related disease. Thank you.